Gradients have just had an update in Photoshop 2022. This is for PC and Mac. And if you go to the gradient tool, you see along the top, you've got the option here of method. And now you've got perceptual, linear, and classic. Now these ones are slightly unusual and you can see the results. So I've got here perceptual, that's the top one. You've got linear and you've got classic. Now, classic was the one that you used in 2021, 2020, etc. This one is linear and is more like sort of Illustrator, apparently. I was reading the documentation. I must admit, that's the case. And it's apparently natural light. Now, this one is perceptual. This is apparently how gradients are displayed to the eye and probably more pleasing to the eye. Now, of course, with all these things, I think it really depends on what you like, because it is exactly the same gradient. It's been applied and I've just used exactly the same one over here, the gradient tool. And well, which one do you prefer when you use it? I'm actually quite happy with this one. I think the linear for me works best, but each to their own. Well, what else can you do with this? Obviously it's nice to have that applied. Well, you can, I think it actually works really nice if you combine them. And that's one great thing about gradients, you can combine them. So I'm just going to go now to the gradient tool and you've got perceptual. So if I go for perceptual and I'm just going to quickly clear this down. So let's just quickly just make that to black, doesn't particularly matter. And I'm just going to apply. Apply it like that. And now I'm just going to go to blend mode of difference and apply it like that. And you've got quite none. And apply it a couple of times and you can see the effect there. Now if I undo, and I'm going to go now to the classic. Apply it again, and obviously because I've applied it slightly different, you do actually see a slightly different result from one to the other. So I think the combination of gradients using the different methods also is certainly worth checking out. So if you want to try out different designs, I think using that combination is quite good. What you can also do, of course, gradients are spread throughout Photoshop. So in 2022, you can find it in a number of areas, gradient fills. So I'm just going to go to a layer and down to new fill layer. So you've got new fill layer and gradient. So select that and you got click there. Now it's not available at that point, but there is, if you go down there now to the gradient fill, see down the bottom, you've got perceptual and you can do exactly the same as before. You can change it to linear and you can see then you've got that sort of spreads out in a slightly different way. And go to classic. Now, when you store a gradient, you've got here the gradients, that does not store the classic, perceptual, etc. So you can select a gradient, you need to set it here. So just go to linear and you can go backwards and forwards. However, I think it's slightly confusing they've gone for linear here, because you can see a slight problem because the style has got linear as well. So anyway, that's a minor issue, but I just think, now, when you're searching for it, makes it very hard to find. And there's actually very little information, even on the actual Photoshop help. In fact, it doesn't seem to mention it at all, which is very odd. So you can see now you've got linear. And of course, with this, you can create multiple. So just go for layer, and I'm going to duplicate that one. And again, you don't have to keep the same. So you can click on that, and you can go, well, I'm going to go for perceptual this time. And then click OK. And then I can use blending. You can now see the difference. So just going to go through. It's very subtle. That's the difference between the two. So you can just see there's a bit more green there and there's a bit of red there. And obviously, really depends on the gradient. So you may choose different gradients and the results will be different. So, I mean, if I just click there and say, let's go for this one. Just going to go for that one, the blue, and click that one again. And just go up there again to the blue one. And you can see again, there is a subtle difference between the two. So it's worth checking out. And also, of course, you can combine them in many other ways as well. Now, if I just go here to layer and flatten, because what I want to do now is go to the next obvious one. And that's layer. Ah, I need a layer. That's really helpful. So just these there. So I've now got a layer. And I can go to layer and layer style. And I'm going to go down to gradient overlay. So gradient overlay, and you can see there, exactly the same. You've got the method, you can go through linear, you can use classic. Now some, it's hardly any difference at all. So you've got some, you just see when I've gone through those, very little difference. But if you go for say this one, and then select classical linear. You can see that spreads it out more. Obviously, clearly, some gradients, it will be a bigger impact than with others. With others, might not hardly notice a thing. So classic there. Again, the blue seems to spread out more. Obviously, that seems to be a really sensible thing. Perceptual, and again, you've got blue there as well. So click OK. However, there are a few areas where this is missed out. And I'm going to actually bring this back again because I want to put this one out, which is a pity because I'm just going to go down to stroke. Now, stroke, if you go down here to, what's the colour? Gradient. That was, I knew where I was looking. You see here, there's no method. For some weird reason, it's been forgotten about, which is very strange. I don't know why that's left off. Maybe it's a bug. Maybe just no one ever thought about looking there. But to me, it should be there as well. However, see, that's another one I'm just going to have a quick look at. If you go down here, of course, shape burst also. Again, obviously, it doesn't appear. Now, that would have been nice if you've actually had a variety of methods there for that as well. But still, obviously, that's been forgotten about. I don't know about the other ones. Inner glow comes to mind, another one. So, no, inner glow also does not have with the, that's very strange. So, that's gradients running through and, well, can't think of any other. That's probably, someone will turn around afterwards and say, you forgot this area of gradients. But I just wanted to point out this new method. I think it's really nice. I think it's a really good feature. I think if you just go down here, and again, just go to the gradient tool and go through the method. Actually, I think by default, I will just test depending on the gradient. Just gives a lot more options, a lot more ways of blending colours together and using different. So I think great. However, personally, I think this is a slightly missed opportunity if they're going to update this area of the method. At the same time, I would have loved if they'd introduced a few more different, maybe a shape burst feature here. Would have been great. Awesome. I just thought of one just before I finish. Of course, shapes. If we go to shape, just create a shape. You can go here and you can go to the fill and gradient. And you can select that. And now that also has down there perceptual and obviously linear. So you can change, create some interesting colour combinations there as well. Which actually, of course, also gives you the opportunity, once you've got decided on that, of course, you've got the option here of stroke as well. So again, click there. And that also, luckily, has got that feature. So you can add stroke. So I'm just going to quickly add one. Let's just extend this a bit. So you've got that there. And then I can click on there and obviously change it from perceptual to linear. Now that black and white, that does change quite substantially. Again, let's go for linear perceptual. You can see subtle changes between the two. Yeah. The blues definitely seem to be the thing that really changes quite, what's known between the different methods. But there it's available, gives you a lot more opportunities. And of course, also what you can do, and that was one of the things I was going to quickly go for, select there. You've also got the option of layer, and you can turn this into a smart object. So convert to smart object. So it's a smart object. And then of course what you can do, layer style, and you can go down to gradient overlay as well. So you can blend that and then blend that as well with difference. And again, you've got options here with linear and classic. So you can vary between them. Gives a lot more options, I think. Gradient maps have also been updated. What you can do, go to image menu and down to adjustments and down to gradient map. The gradient map, you can see default one is not very useful. However, you can select one of these other gradients. And of course, you've got thousands of gradients to choose from. So select one of them and you can run through them and maybe go with this one, rainbow one. So you can see the full range of colours. Now you've got this method. Method exactly the same as before, linear and classic. Fairly subtle. Also, you can go, say, for a different one there. I'm just going to go for maybe that one. And again, linear, perceptual. Again, very subtle. But once you're happy with that, go for perceptual. You can apply it. But also what you can do, you can go to a layer menu and new adjustment layer and down to gradient map. It's just down the bottom. Always look for it. I must admit, each and every time. Then you've got that. Click OK. And what it does, again, defaults to the very unusual gradient here. Just going to go for that one. Or anything else other than just a solid colour. And again, just go through it, linear. And again, that changes. Actually, the yellows really kick in there. And classic. So it will vary. Really depends, obviously, on the image. So different images, you'll get different results. So that one, classic, linear, perceptual. Again, really depends on what you want to achieve with your gradient map. Well, I hope you found this interesting. And I'm also going to be adding some other videos about some of the other features of Photoshop, the latest release. Most often, I will be doing videos on things that are probably slightly more obscure features, because it's not hardly mentioned at all about the gradient. Yet I think this is one of the best features that's been added. Bye.